Good afternoon. This is Mistress Glove Love speaking from the King Dom Clinic. And how can I help you today? I see. Right. You saw our advert. Well, I'm very pleased to see that that's doing very well. Okay. And you're an entry level. You've never experienced this before. Oh, a newbie to it. I see. But you have your own fetishes. Wonderful. Can I ask you a couple of questions? Let me just have a look here through my book. Now, where did you say you're from? You're an exchange student. Currently living abroad. No friends or family here then? Okay, that's not a problem. And you're looking for some medical roleplay, is that correct? A little pretend play in medical care, yes? Well, you've come to the right place, haven't you? Now, we're running a very good special offer at the moment. 60% off your first session with the full package, if that's something you'd be interested in. I can run you through the scenario indeed. So you'd be looking at a medical kidnapping. That's right. I will turn up at your home in my van, collect you. It's all going to feel very immersive and very real. I pride myself on it feeling realistic, but don't be too worried. No harm will come to you, of course. Yes, yeah, so there'll be some medical procedures, nothing serious. Of course, it's all role play. That's right. We'll create a safe word for you, so if there's anything you don't like, I'm sure there's no way we can go against your wishes. Well, you sound like the perfect candidate. Go back online and pop the deposit in. Fill out the date and time, and you can wait for your appointment. I'm sure you're going to be very excited waiting for me to turn up for you. Perfect. Wonderful. Oh, and just one extra thing, Christoph. It really can feel quite realistic at times, but I don't want you to worry at all. You're in safe hands, you know that, don't you, Christoph? Good. Good boy. Well, I'll be with you very soon. Foolish little ones. Foolish, foolish, foolish. All alone in this country. No friends. No family. Nobody to miss him. Sounds like he needs a little tender care, doesn't he? Oh yes, I'm sure you'll find the whole experience very immersive. You'll feel like it's all very realistic at times, but you mustn't be taken in by that. And don't worry yourself too much. Of course, I'll be with you the entire time. That's correct. Yes, I will turn up in my van, and then I will also knock on the door. You'll feel like it's really quite realistic, if you know what I mean. I want you to get the full experience as you have booked the full package. Yes. No fear. You're going to love every second of it. He better be home waiting for me. He's got a time and date. He's expected to be there. just where you've wanted to be. In my safe medical hands. Oh, that's it. Wonderful, I see you waking up at last. Yeah. Feeling a bit chilly? Well, that would be because you're all naked on my medical table. Of course. Look at you, laid out there, sprawled out. Well, this is it. I hear you're just experiencing this for the first time. Is that correct? Well, you are lucky. You got me. That's it. I know you're feeling a little bit groggy. Don't worry about that. You'll come round in no time. Now, very importantly, I need you to do something for me. Just get you a little pen. That's right. Give me your arm. Lift your arm up. I'm going to need you to sign your consent form now. All right? I know you feel a little bit tired. Come, come. You can do it. Pop your signature on there. That's it. That's it. Write it. Wonderful job. There we are. Now you're all signed up officially. Very good. Very good indeed, to be honest. I was beginning to wonder if I was going to have to force your hand. Now, let's talk about today then, shall we? So you've just signed away all rights to your own medical care now. That's it. You've signed them away to me. Yes, you have. And I'm going to be taking excellent care of you. Yeah. I see you're gaining back a little bit more strength there, aren't you? Well, why don't we just make sure that there's absolutely no chance that you're going anywhere. I'm just going to strap down your arm. That's one side. Let's get the other side strapped in, shall we? There we are, we'll just take that over to the other side and strap you down there. I'm going to be strapping your legs down as well. All part of your procedure. Nothing for you to worry about, is there? I'm just going to take these Velcro ties and tie you down to the bed. Let's get one on that side. Spread these legs apart a little, shall we? Pop one down on here for you. There we are. And just in case I have any little issues, I'll handcuff you to the bars on the side of your bed. All right? But I don't think we need any added restraints, do we? There's a good boy. It's all in your contract, everything you wanted to happen to you. Now, I'm going to give you a little quick once over. There you are, see? Feeling more at ease already, aren't you? That's right. So, let's have a quick check of your heart rate. I would personally anticipate it's going to be very elevated. And if it's not, there's something wrong with you. Let's just pop that down onto your chest. Let me listen for a while. There's something so wonderful about the sound of a heartbeat in my hands. Yes. You're sounding fine. Nothing to worry about there. So that's good, isn't it? Now, quick check up on those eyes for you. Can you follow the light for me? Follow the light. Left to right, right to left. Follow the light down, all the way over. Take the light up to the left. Good boy. And down to the right. Excellent. Small amount of dilation there. Nothing I need worry about. Now, for my favourite medical check of all. Let's check what's happening here between your legs, shall we? Let's just manoeuvre ourselves right back here. Come, come, don't tighten up and tense and squeeze those legs together. Look at that. You've given me plenty to work with, haven't you? Is that a little bit of excitement I see there? That'll soon wear off. I'm sure. Yes. Well, I know this is your entry-level first time. But I think you'll find this experience something very alternative and very satisfying. You see? Now, let's have a look. What procedures we're going to be doing with you today. I'll be doing a full and thorough examination of your lower regions. That's correct. Yes, I'll be checking your manhood and your rectal area. Oh, yes. I'm sure it will be very enjoyable. In my capable hands, of course. Well, you needn't worry too much. I'm very gentle when I want to be. Let's just have a little further examination down there, shall we? Just a little further look-see. Let's go in there and have a little look. Oh, lovely shape on it. Looks like it could have quite a bit of power behind it. Won't do when I'm finished with you, I'm afraid. Won't do at all. No, you see, when I'm finished with you, you're not going to be the man you are at all. You'll be quite different. You will. I've got some wonderful surgery planned for you. Some deep probing. And, well, you might even end up, shall we say, short an appendage or two. Oh, we shall see. We shall see. Now, I think what we need to do is get you prepped for surgery, my love. Yeah. You wait there. Got a little something for you. Now, I've already popped an IV in your arm. So I'm just going to give you a little injection. That's right. Oh no, not at all. Just a bit of saline, you see? Do you think it's a bit of saline? Because that's what you asked for, wasn't it? Shall I tell you something? It's a paralytic. I'm going to inject this into your arm. And once it's injected, you will be completely and utterly paralyzed. Yes. Stop wiggling. You don't need to be quite so worried. Let's just put this in. Are you ready? It's going to go in now. Here we go. Let's pop that button down into your arm. All the way in. Now, in just a few moments, you're going to get really drowsy. And when you wake up, you'll be all prepped for surgery.
Good boy.
Now, now. You're going to have to wake up a little for me. Come on now. It's time for your surgery. Look at you. With your legs all wide for me. Are you ready? I know you know that we've got quite a lot to be getting on with today, don't we? Yes, we do. Let's have a little look-see under here, shall we? There, we'll just roll that back. Let's pop that just there for me. Oh, look at these legs. Long legs you've got, aren't they? I do like to stroke the inner thigh sometimes. You needn't squirm, you know. There's no getting out. You're securely tied down. Course, as it says in your contract. Now, you did sign your waiver, didn't you? You did, I remember you doing so. And that waiver clearly mentioned, wait a moment, let me close it for you. Got it right here. Clearly notes that you've given full consent, note full consent for all surgeries, procedures, and any work I deem fit to do on you. So, you signed it, didn't you? Yes. So, we'll simply have to get on with the procedures then, won't we? You'd like to know what I'm going to be doing with you today. It's a little complex, I'm not going to lie. However, you seem bright enough to me. I mean, you are a student after all. So, the first thing we're going to do... Oh, did you see how excited I got then? The first thing we're going to do is I'm going to insert a catheter straight down the shaft of your penis. Yes, that's right. And then I'm going to inject you with a little something I like to refer to as a paralytic. I mean, you've already had a paralytic, but this is a very special concoction that I've made up just to make sure that the whole area is, well, completely pliable for me. So that's number one. Then, of course, we'll move down a little bit. We'll be going down and working on your rectum. Yes, that's right. I'll be working my way deep into your rectum. And once I'm finished with that, well, we'll get to that when we get there. So why don't we get started? As you're looking ever so comfortable there for me and oh so vulnerable. There's nothing I love more than a vulnerable patient. Truly. Now first of all, I don't want any accidents during this procedure. So let's get you all rigged up for that. Nice IV that I popped in earlier. That's correct. Get all our tubes and wiring in place. I'm just going to pop that down. That'll be hanging down from here. There we are. Just pop that in there. I'm just going to plug that in. And we'll bring that down here. Tube into place there. Pop that in a moment. Now also, I want to make sure we're all nicely hydrated. Today, don't we? I certainly don't want any dehydration from you. We can't have that, can we? No. So let's get you all plugged into your drip. Good boy. Let's take that up there. There we go. Just get that all plugged in. Lovely. Oh, there we are. Plugged in comfortably. Perfect. Wonderful. Well, then I think it's time, my dear,
surgery. What do you think? Oh, I'm sure you're ready, aren't you? Right, let's get straight in then. First of all today, I'm going to be inserting this tube, the full length of it, right into the shaft of your penis. That's right, forcing it all the way up into your urethra. So, I've got here a little spray. There we are. And that's going to relax your penis a little bit for me. Not that it's going to make a great deal of difference, but still, we're going to be sliding it in. Alright, let me just get a hold of the end there. Then I'm just peeling the hole open. Ooh, that's a tight squeeze, isn't it? Okay, I'm going to go in, force that in. I'd suggest deep breaths if I were you. All the way in, yep, wonderful. Right, that seems to be perfectly in place now. Now, I've got two little syringes ready for you today. And what these will do is just paralyse the area. Yes, they will. They'll just paralyse them. Yes, my love. I'm going to inject this into your penis. Don't mind, do you? I didn't think so. Right. Let's put this down here then. Have you all ready? Right then. Now, well, we're just getting the end of that tube. Do you see it? Yes? Well, you're not the most well-endowed I've ever seen, but it's large enough to do the trick. Now, just going to insert that needle down into the tube, and you'll feel a cold sensation making you want to wet yourself. But I highly suggest you don't. Alright. Does that feel like ice running through the tip of your penis? Does it indeed? I'm sure it does. Wonderful. Job number one done. There you are. Give that a couple of minutes to do its job. Soon you won't be feeling a thing in that area. Isn't that wonderful? No. Next on my agenda, little bit lower than the penis area, we'll be going into the rectum. Now for this, I really am going to have to loosen those muscles up, because I'll be going in exceptionally deep today. Right, let's get you all open, that's it. It's going to hold you there, and there we go. Yeah, we'll do it. I'm just going to give you a little tickle down there. That's it. We're going to ease the rectum open. There you go. Ooh, I could get a little tip in there, but I won't. No, we won't be doing anything so crude, I'm afraid. Instead, we'll be using this today. This is my speculum, and it's going to open you all up for me. Perfect, isn't it? Now, there we go. Well, that's done the trick. You're positively gaping down there now. Right, I'm going to just slide this in a little. There we go. All right, deep breaths while you feel it opening. Breathe, there's no point in you passing out, I've told you. I like it when you're awake for the treatment. Here we are. Just want to get you really wide. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, that's perfect. Now let's have a little look in there. Let's have a little look. Just need to get a look in here. Oh, I can see all the way down inside of you. I can see what you had for breakfast if you'd had any. But you didn't have any, did you? Because you were here laying on my table passed out. I suppose I'll have to feed you at some stage. Right. Oh, lovely. Well, I've got a perfect view of what I'm going to be doing today. So, what we might do actually, I'm just going to take this clamp and clamp open your bottom hole. Yeah, I'm going to pop that in there. Just unscrew this. Do you know, it's such an old implement, you wouldn't believe I still use it, but it's just one of those things, it's just the best. I'm going to slide that in one side. There we go, I'm just going to hold the skin of one side. Oh, that's held it tightly open now, hasn't it? Gosh, that's tightly open there. Skin's positively stretched apart. Right, where's that lovely magnifying glass? Now, today's procedure is going to involve a little scalpel. Yes, that's right. I'm going to be doing a little bit of cutting. Yes, we're going to be cutting and slicing away at your insides. And we might, if I can't quite get what I need, have to get in with my surgical shears. Well, let's make a start, shall we? Seeing as you're all gaping there for me. It's lovely. Right, let's have a little look, see then, shall we? Right, let's get in there then. Okay. I need to go in with a scalpel on the left. Deep breaths up there. Just going to slice that away. Going in on the right. It's actually quite a minor procedure, you know. Of course, you won't ever have that pleasure in your rectum again once I'm finished. Nearly there. I am going to go in with these little fellas and just snip that away completely. Oh, that looks fabulous. Right, okay, let me just find something. There we are. Let's just get in for a second. I just need to slide that out. There we are. Oh, you're a bit of a mess down here now, I'm afraid. Get that a little cleaner. So that is your prostate removed. I've taken it out. Just removed your prostate. I'm going to be pulling this out now. Oh, let's just squeeze that closed. There we are. Yes. No more prostate for you. No, it's one of those things, isn't it? Now, I have to say, I was going to stop there. But you see, you've still got this marvellous little tube sticking out of your penis. And I seem to have numbed the entire area. So I'm afraid, well, I was thinking about it anyway, but I think I might have to just go in with a little extra surgery for you. And as I've got you here all laid out, it would seem such a waste, wouldn't it? I am going to have to go in with the industrial double gloving for this one. Gets a bit messier, this one, you see. A lot of blood flow to the area, if you know what I mean. Can take quite a bit of clearing up afterwards. But we've got all the time in the world, don't we? Yes, we do. All the time in the world. This is gonna hurt. La 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 na 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 na. You got all the time in the world, and I am gonna take my time with you. Try not to pass out, won't you? Here, have a little gas. See if that doesn't keep you going for a bit.
Come on.
Take a few breaths. You'll be fine. Last little jobsy. I'm going to need this again. For this job. Here we are. Little slice around there. Oh no, you can't feel anything. You mustn't worry. I know you can't feel anything. Because that catheter I inserted with that lovely little concoction of mine means you definitely can't feel what I'm doing, can you? No. So I don't know what all your squirming and moaning's for. I am going to need these though. Just going to chop that off. Chop that off. Chop that so- Oh, it's nearly off. It's nearly off. You look like a girl now.
Oh dear. Right. Oh dear, it's getting a bit...
Okay. Oh right, okay. Getting a little bit out of hand here. Okay, what I suggest... Take some oxygen for me. Take a few breaths. That's it. Take it in. Breathe it in. Good job. Get that in you. I'm just going to have a little tidy up down here. Stitch up a few little things. And get you all tip-top again. And, yeah, I'll wake you up. You're going to pass out on me. Look at you. I know, I see it. It might have been a little bit of blood loss. Don't worry, just a little bit of blood loss. You're going to be absolutely fine. Absolutely fine. You'll wake up in my arms.
Wakey, wakey, Christoph. How are you feeling? A little better, I hope. You are. You're in the recovery room. Still feeling very groggy. Does it all feel like a bit of a dream?
Yes, it does to me too.
Well, Christoph, I think we'll finish up with you today. I'm going to just do the very last of my procedures on you. You can't feel your legs? Oh, I don't suppose you can. I put an awful lot of paralytic in there. It's highly unlikely you can feel it at all. Now, what you need to do is build up some sustenance, don't we? We need to build you up. Yes, we do. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to wedge this into your mouth. To force it open. That's right. Get in nice and close to you now. Let's force this over. Let's get it on. And get that clipped in all the way. Let's keep that mouth of yours nice and tightly open. Well done. Well done. You know, sometimes I worry that you'll get a bit excited and bite through those. Let's have a look if I can't find a nice little white bit for you. You've got quite a large mouth, I think. The largest one will do.
I think we'll just slide that in as well.
That's it. You can bite down on the sides.
There you are.
Now, you won't be doing anything and you certainly won't be closing your mouth, will you? Well, good. Because I'm going to be taking this tube and I'm going to be inserting it into your gullet. That's right. It's going to come down from here and slide down into your mouth. Oh, is that uncomfortable? Don't you worry. Let's get it slid down all the way. Oh, there it is. Just popping out the top of your mouth. Don't you look wonderful? Just laid out there for me. Yes, I did put my glasses on, and do you know why? Sometimes patients can get a bit gaggy, a bit gag reflex on me, and it gets all a bit spitty, and I don't want that. Safety first, my love. Safety first, my love. Now, you hold up there while I get you your very special mixture. Now, what do you think's in here? Hey, what do you think I've got all blended up in there for you? Have you worked it out yet? No? Well, let's feed this tube down inside of there. Oh, squeeze that down into your gullet. You really haven't worked it out yet. Okay, perhaps I can enlighten you then. I'm going to be feeding you your own manhood today. I blitzed it up with your prostate. I'd keep gulping if I were you. That whole lot needs to go down. Yes. Let's see if we can't take that out now. It's all emptied. Oh. Well. You know, you're not leaving here. You didn't think that you were done, did you? Oh, I'm afraid not. Not at all. No. You see, now you're my medical patient. And there's simply nobody to come and find you. I'm afraid you'll have to stay here with me. As I have so many more procedures I'd like to do on you. Oh, I'm afraid you're wrong there. You did sign up for this. When you signed that waiver, should have read the small print, really, shouldn't you? Yeah. You signed all your rights away. You are my medical guinea pig. Thank you so much. It's truly been quite a pleasure working with you. I've loved it, and I thoroughly look forward to a little bit more surgery with you very soon. You lay back now and have another little sleep. Perhaps we can pop something in that IV of yours. Knock you out a bit longer. Don't worry, I'll bring you round when I need you next. Sweet dreams, Christoph.